Actually, portal means in second slide. Portal is a web application where you can personalize everything as you need, like iGoogle and Yahoo. If you log into the iGoogle and Yahoo, you'll find many of the small application on the web page. You can customize. You can based on your need. You can change the theme, look and feel, and application that you want to use there. Position, layout, anything. What are the portals in open source? What are the portals in the open source? In open source, there are many portals. Like if you go to the PHP, then you'll find WordPress. That is also a portal. You'll find Joomla, Drupal. But in Java, there are open source portals like Pluto. That is Apache Foundation project, and that is the implementation of first Java portlet specification, portlet 1.0. And after 2009, this specification is actually discontinued the support. In real world, we are not using Pluto and JetSpeed. JetSpeed is also another project of Apache Foundation. That is the implementation of Portlet 2.0 framework. And Portlet 2.0 framework is also implemented in JBoss portal, but this is continued after 2010. Next open source portal is LifeRay. LifeRay portal is also providing you all the portlet specification that is currently used in the market. And the next, the JBoss portal is, JBoss community has a partnership between EXO platform, and that is a new portal, Getin, that is provided by JBoss community and EXO platform. And that is also a good platform for portal. And first we need to know what the portal is and what the features portal should have. Basic portal features. As you, if you go to the iGoogle and Yahoo and another portals, then you will find this is very user-friendly, and you can customize based on your needs. So dynamic look and feel is the first basic features of the any portal. Personalization. User can put any application anywhere. If you go to the iGoogle, then you'll find a simple chunks of applications where you can move the application from one page to another page, or you can remove also. Like if you see here, weather port, this is called portlets, but because this is the simple small chunk of application. Here one Gmail portlet is there, Google Talk is there. And if you want to remove this, you can go to the settings and remove. You can remove. There are many gadgets are there. You can delete, minimize, maximize, many things you can do. You can personalize yourself after login. CMS. CMS is also best part of the any portal. In any portal, if you want to create a page, and on the page you want to give some contents, no need to do any HTML changes, JSP changes, and all that. All the things you need to do is only you need to put one web content portlet. Like portlet is an application, like you see in the iGoogle. Like that, only one web content portlet you need to place and put the content as you want. And the content you can put in HTML format, JavaScript, anything. You can put it there. Document management. in every portal, whatever you upload, that is a document, like files, videos, anything. You can upload in a document management, any document management you know, SharePoint, like SharePoint document management, Alfresco is a document management, but portals has some basic document management features, and it is like you can it is also controlling the version numbers of documents also. And if you want to integrate SharePoint and Alfresco, then you can integrate with these portals also. But if you want basic features, then every portal should have a basic document management features. Forums. Every portals has one application like forum. You can start any threads and any questions there. Like if you see in Google Groups, mails, if you send any mail, then it will be grouped by all the peoples. Means all the peoples are in the group will see and answer it if you have any questions. Like that, one forum portlets is available, or forum application will be available in the portal. Blogs, you can write a blogs. If you see WordPress is only for blogging, but so it is not a complete portal. But if you go to the complete portal solution, then you can have you may have all the portlets, all the application there. You can put that application on any page. Like there are enterprise portals like WebSphere, WebLogic also has these types of features. Wiki, workflow, easy integration with other applications like LDAP, social API. One of the popular open source portal is LifeRay. What LifeRay provides you? LifeRay provides all the basic portal features that is I showed you in the last slide. And LifeRay provides you the functionality of like iGoogle. You can drag and drop any application on the page. Any application that is by default provided by LifeRay. It is in my system actually. I'll show you how to do this, but projector is not connecting here in my laptop. Okay. If you see iGoogle, LifeRay also provides on these types of page. You can create any page and you can put any application like Google Talk. If you want Google Talk down, then you can put it down. Google Calendar. All these by default out-of-box portlets provides you by LifeRay. Like which features are there? Page and layout management, user management. You no need to create any API for users. It will only it will default provided by LifeRay. If you create any user registration, all the things are provided by LifeRay. If you want to use in your application in custom development, then you can use that API in your application. User management, virtual site creation. This is the main features, virtual site creation. Virtual site creation means if you have one portal, one portal may have more than one sites. Means like abcd.com, xyz.com, you can create a virtual host there and it will create a new instance for you in the portal. You create a page in your site and make it as you want. Only you need to do is you have to go to the server configuration and you have to map the URL for that virtual machine or virtual site.
So we can keep the look and feel and data, everything will be separate.
Yeah, data, everything will be separate. The end user will not find anything similar between other sites.
Like you can, you showed that example of iGoogle. There can be like iGoogle and on the same backend server, you're want.
No, no, this is one of the example of iGoogle. If you go to the yahoo.com, then mail.yahoo.com look and feel and everything is different, but yahoo.com main site is different, yahoo.com India is different, yahoo.in is different, and yahoo.com US is different. All the things are other portals, different sites, different themes are applied on that. That are virtual sites, but running on the same portal. User group management. If you want, this user will be the admin user, this has all the privilege, then you can provide all the privilege for that user, and that user will create anything. But if you want some users has some limited permissions and frameworks, then it will apply only for that site or that organization. And integration of social APIs like Google, Facebook and Yahoo. Liferay provides you all the things in one go. Actually, Liferay has one ESB. All the things, all the external application, you can connect through ESB. ESB means Enterprise Service Bus, and all the information or configuration you need to provide on one portlet, portal est.properties file. What are the advanced features Liferay provides you? Advanced features, if you want to, there are some of the portlets that is already available out of the box. But if you want any other application that is available on marketplace, like Android marketplace, if you want to use the other application, you can log in to the marketplace and download it and apply here. Liferay Sync. Liferay Sync is an application. That application is like a Dropbox. Dropbox means Liferay document management system files and all you can see your files, public files or private files also, you can access in your desktop like Dropbox. It will sync. Liferay Social Office. Social office means you have your online office. Online office means which task is provided for whom, and which contacts are there, notification, which team is working on which task. That is you can use on Liferay Social Office. That is like a social API, like you can say Yammer. There is one application, one social office. Like Facebook, Yammer is there. Document and sharing, document media sharing, all that. Liferay custom development. Custom development means if you have all the applications in Liferay previously installed, and you have installed most of the application from marketplace, but that application is not fulfilling your requirements, then what will you do? Then you can create your own application using Portlet 2.0 API, because right now in the market the latest specification of Portlet is 2.0, and Liferay provides you the custom plugin portlet development that is ANT based or Maven based. Use whatever you want. The second thing is theme and layout. For changing the layout and themes, look and feel, you have to create independent theme, and that theme will apply on any of the Liferay sites, but depends on the version number. The you can't deploy the latest version number theme to older Liferay. Customization Liferay using hook. Using hook means Liferay provides you the functionality of changing the functionality of a Liferay that is by default available. Means if you want to change user management and all that functionality, then you can create hook. And if you want to change the functionality of Liferay that is a core functionality, then you have to create a EXT plugin. EXT plugin, extension plugin, if you create, then you can change the portal IMPL. Actually, there are two jar files are there in the root that is available for use for external purpose. There is portal IMPL.jar. You can change it using hook, but there are service plugin that is service jar that is only changed by ext. What framework supports Liferay? Basically, Liferay is the base of Liferay is on three frameworks. Struts. All the out-of-box portlets are developed in Struts, and all the service layer implementation that is on the Spring 2.5, and the ORM framework is on Hibernate. All these things has Liferay has provided one more implementation on these things, like Struts portlet framework, like its own Liferay ORM framework on top of Hibernate for exposing the new services from Liferay server. It is by default using Apache Access. Integration with other application. Other application, like if you want to integrate your SharePoint, if you want to integrate LDAP and all other application, then only one source of this doing this is ESB. Internally, Liferay reads one file, that is portal ext.properties. Here you can change anything. You can change, provide the configuration of your SharePoint server or Facebook also, if you want to integrate with Facebook. Anything you can provide here. BPMN, like Business Processing Modeling Notation Server, and what are the server? Activity Server, all that. Dropbox, Salesforce, Google services, that also you can integrate with Mule ESB or Service Mix ESB. I had some code in my system, but that is not, I'm not able to show here because the projector issue. If you have any question, you can ask.
Regarding that virtual side that you talked about, mm-hmm. Sir, I'm doubtful how it works on the backend. Means database.
In the database, it will create a one group for that. On this group, is belongs to that site. For each and every site, there are different groups. For each and every user also, you can create one site. Like in Facebook, you have your own profile, like your own personal website. Like you can create in sites in Google's also, in your profile. Like in public profile, like LinkedIn, like that only you can create also here. But all the sites has different group ID, and based on the group ID, it will be different here.
But
the database is common. If you want, you can cluster your database also. It is on the development other DB related task. You can clustering your server also, and in one server you can create many of the instance also. Many of the instance means another site. There are two ways to creating sites. Many ways you create personal sites, organization site, user group sites, or instantiate another Liferay portal. But if one user is belongs to site one, if he has the privilege, then he can look into the another site also. But if you have another instance, the user of this instance can't see the another instance anything. No, he will not able to see anything.
On one portal itself, there you have implemented three different instances, mm-hmm. But the users on each of the instances
are independent.
But they cannot interview.
No.
Data.
If one instance has many sites, then user can has have the privilege to look into the another site also. But if you have another instance, then one of user of one instance can't see anything on the user of second instance.
Instance means that
a virtual site that you can no, virtual machine. Instance means virtual machine, virtual server. Means it is completely independent of one server.
But in that case, like a virtual site that you talked about, there a user on what virtual site can see the data from?
Yeah. If he has privilege. If he has admin user, then he can see any of the sites, but in one instance. One instance admin can see all the things, all the sites, all the organization in one instance, but he can't see the another instance things. And any questions on this portal related technologies? Else, I might, maybe that is the problem of a projector. I can show you in the laptop only if you want.